Hey everybody, Dave K here. Today, I want to talk to you about 10 of my favorite things to do in the Magic Kingdom. So if you've never been to the Magic Kingdom before, or maybe if you have, and you want to hear some of my favorites, some things you may want to check out, listen in. Let's do it. How's it going, everyone? Let us talk today about 10 of my favorite attractions and or things to do in the Magic Kingdom. So I wanted to set it up this way. First of all, a little preface here. Wanted to set it up this way so that we could touch on not just attractions, but also some of my favorite restaurants or some of my favorite nighttime shows, some of those spectaculars, fireworks shows. Want to take together all of the components of a park and put together just like the 10 of my favorites. So let me know what you think of that idea. Would you rather hear just about rides, or would you rather hear just about fireworks or restaurants, or do you kind of like the idea of all in one? Or maybe I should do videos on each of them. Let me know what you think. But getting us started here with number one. And these are in no particular order, I think. You know, they sort of came to mind in this order, so maybe they are favorites in this order, but I'll touch on all of them and let me know what you think. So number one for me is Space Mountain. I absolutely love Space Mountain. If you've never been on Space Mountain before, it is a high-intensity coaster. It does move pretty quickly, so if you don't love roller coasters, you may not love this ride, but it's in the dark. It's kind of like a journey through space. Really, really exciting adventure. Really unique, again, because it's in the dark, and it takes you through this mountain where you're on this journey. You sort of see what some of this space launch work would be like. So it is a high-intensity roller coaster. Now, one of the reasons this is number one for me is because of the wait time. So one of the first reasons I thought of it is, if you're looking to go to Space Mountain, you may want to consider going either early in the morning, or you may want to consider getting a fast pass for Space Mountain, because that's one of those rides at the Magic Kingdom which you may find quite a wait for. So it's something to keep in mind. If you're interested in trying Space Mountain or going back on Space Mountain, keep in mind you may want a fast pass for that one. Number two for me, second ride that I would choose to go on, and one of my top 10 highlights, is the Splash Mountain. I absolutely love Splash Mountain. Now, again, there is a very high intensity drop near the end of Splash Mountain, and you may get wet. So first of all, if you have a camera or any other technology you're worried about, make sure you get a bag from one of the shops. Wrap your camera in a bag or a poncho or something along those lines, just to make sure that those electronics don't get soaked. But overall, it really is a fun ride. I like this one a lot. Honestly, for me, one of my favorite things about Splash Mountain is the theming and the music. I feel like the animatronics and the characters in the story and the attention to detail in this ride, as well as the music in this ride, really make it what it is. I absolutely love the theming and the music of Splash Mountain. For me, even if they took out the splash, I absolutely love, again, the songs, the way they've written those songs, the story they tell built into that ride. It's absolutely fantastic. One more piece on Splash Mountain I forgot to touch on. It can also have quite a wait. So if you're thinking about riding Splash Mountain, again, also consider going early in the morning or grabbing yourself a fast pass, because that line can be quite long. Again, end of the day is another good time to look at those rides, because it can be your last ride of the night. As long as you're in line before the park closes, you'll be able to go on that ride. So this is just a couple of ideas for you to make sure that you can try those rides in case you haven't tried Splash Mountain before, how you can optimize your trip to make sure you can get on that ride. Now, ride number three, another ride I love, a classic for me, is Pirates of the Caribbean. Absolutely amazing story. I love the music that goes with pirates and the story that goes with pirates. And I think that's really what makes the ride amazing. You know, it's not a high-intensity ride. It does kind of go through the dark. You do see a lot of scenes from different sort of pirate stories. It's really about Captain Jack and how he collects his treasure and people chasing him. But overall, really, really a great story, a great ride with some great music and some great theming. There are some slight drops, really no intense drops on that one, but there are mild drops. So in case you're worried about getting wet, just something to keep in mind. You may get a little bit wet on this ride. Definitely not as wet as Splash Mountain, but it's a fun one. Overall, I would say Pirates is another one of my favorites. I like to go on it whenever I'm in the park. Now, another really fun coaster with high intensity, but also some amazing theming, probably not as intense as Splash Mountain for me, number four is the Seven Dwarves Mine Train. I really like this one. You know, to me, one of the reasons I love Seven Dwarves Mine Train is the theming. Again, for me, it comes down to a lot of the time, the theming. So if you're on the Seven Dwarves Mine Train, the art that they've built into the ride, the animation and the decoration of those seven dwarves doing their work and singing their songs, to me, that's what makes this ride such an amazing one. So in case, again, in case you're looking for some roller coasters, but with some fantastic theming and some great Disney theming, you may really enjoy the Seven Dwarves Mine Train. Another one to keep your eyes open for. And another one that does have some of the longest wait times, honestly, in the Magic Kingdom at the time of filming. So do keep in mind that may be a good one for looking for fast passes or for trying to go early in the morning or later at night. But again, do keep in mind that I enjoy the ride quite a bit, but it can have quite a wait. Number five. Now, a lot of people may not agree with me on this one. It does have a fairly short queue, but I really love the story. Again, I'm one, I think, for the stories and for the theming and kind of those movie, you know, the things that tell you stories. For me, I guess I'm a story person. So I really enjoy PhilharMagic. Now, PhilharMagic is, again, has a very short queue. Generally, when I'm there, you can just kind of walk into the next group or the next two groups of viewers in that theater. And it is a theater. It's type show. So you'll sit back, you'll watch the show, you'll see it presented on that big screen, and you do put on 3D glasses. Now, the ride may need updating. It may be getting updating soon. We don't know anything about that yet. But I saw it recently, and it was kind of hard to see the 3D animation with the glasses on, especially comparing it to some of the other 3D attractions and 3D rides. But overall, I love the story. I like how Donald takes you through a variety of different adventures. I don't want to give too many spoilers here, but it really is a great one that takes you through some of the classics of Disney, and there's some great music, and there's some great effects. You know, do they call it 3D or 4D, something along those lines, because there's all kinds of effects, you know. It's 3D, and then they have effects as well, so maybe they call that 4D. But overall, it's a great one. I love the show. I love the story. PhilharMagic is one that I try to do from time to time, and again, the queue's generally short on that one. The line is pretty short, so you should be able to walk into the line for that one. Maybe you'll find that when some of those other rides you're looking at are busier, you'll be interested in checking this one out. For me, it is a story that I like a lot, but a lot of people may not agree with me on this one. Let me know what you think in the comments. Number six, and again, this is just kind of when they come to mind, because we're talking about rides, we're talking about shows, we're talking about food, but this one came to mind, Skipper Canteen. I absolutely love Skipper Canteen. The food in Skipper Canteen in the Magic Kingdom is fantastic. Now, there's a couple reasons why I touch on this one. For one, I feel like it's really hard to find some amazing sit-down dining or dining in general in some of the parks, you know? To find a restaurant that just amazes you like you can find at some of the resorts is a little bit harder in some of the parks, but I feel like Skipper Canteen at the Magic Kingdom really does this. They do a fantastic job. We've had a variety of items from here, including that cheesy bread, the steak, all kinds of good stuff. We had that soup. I wasn't a huge fan of that soup, but overall, there's been some amazing items from the Skipper Canteen. They are changing their steak soon, again, at the time of filming here, but really, really do enjoy that one. If you haven't tried it before, Skipper Canteen, I would recommend you check it out. See if you like steak, I would strongly recommend this steak. Now, I did have some of the other items, including like the seafood stew, and it was good, but the steak was really amazing. So if you're a steak person, I really would recommend Skipper Canteen at the Magic Kingdom. Number seven, another ride that I hold dear, is the Buzz Lightyear Space Ranger Spin. Now, again, I do love video games. I'm a video game person, and I really like sort of games where you can get scores and try to beat your high score and play in an adventure, and you really are involved in the attraction. For me, I really love those. So if you do like that sort of thing, you're trying to beat your high score and you want to like be a part of the adventure with Buzz to defeat the evil Emperor Zurg, I would strongly recommend Buzz Lightyear Space Ranger Spin. The wait time on this one is, I would say it's average, it's normal. It's not as long as a Seven Dwarves Mine Train, but it's generally, I feel like, longer than PhilharMagic. So just something to keep in mind there. And again, it's kind of like a dark ride where you sit in the ride, and you ride around the rooms, and you see what's going on in those rooms. But this one has a lot less going on in the rooms, if you will, and more for you to get involved with in the rooms. So you have a what would you refer to this as? I guess it's like a blaster. You've got one of Buzz's blasters, and you're trying to blast the targets, trying to blast some of those villains to defeat the evil Emperor Zurg, to get the high score, that kind of thing. I like this one a lot. It feels like a short ride because it's so much fun. And, you know, everyone's on their quest to get Galactic Hero, trying to get that high score. So really, again, for me, Buzz Lightyear's a classic, and I'm going to ride that one whenever I get the chance. For me, that's really high on my list of things to do in the Magic Kingdom. Number 8. I feel like a staple of the Magic Kingdom, or a ride or attraction that I really enjoy, is the People Mover. I don't know if you've been on the People Mover, but if you have not, it's kind of like a train, but it's an open-air train, and it goes around sort of on an elevated platform around some of the Magic Kingdom. You can also see inside. It takes you through Buzz Lightyear or through the Space Mountain, so you can see sort of some of the work that goes on or some of the ride behind the scenes at the Magic Kingdom. It's really cool, and it gives you that feeling like you're really a part of the original magic. You know, you feel like you're immersed in the original designs and what made Magic Kingdom, you know, different, unique. It was really experiential. It was the beginning of the creation of that magic. It's relaxing. That's one of the things I like about it. And you get to see, again, these different areas. You get to see some of the construction work that they're doing. At the time of filming, again, you get to see Tron and sort of what Tron looks like. But also, you get to see some of the rest of the Magic Kingdom. You get to see the castle, ride by the castle, as well as some of Space Mountain and some of those other areas. So I really enjoy sort of the relaxing vibe and being able to see the views on the People Mover. Number 9 is the Happily Ever After fireworks show. This is one of my favorite nighttime shows, fireworks shows. It really is a fantastic show. The fireworks are really uniquely shaped too. So when different characters' scenes come on, you'll see different shaped fireworks in the sky. It's really, really cool. There's also projections on the castle, which help make this amazing as well. So if you've never seen the nighttime spectacular at Magic Kingdom, I would strongly recommend it. Some of my favorite scenes include the genie scene, where they sing about "That's what friends are for." You may have seen it before. If you have, you probably know what I'm talking about. But you can see some of the projections on the castle where they show you all kinds of cool stuff. There's a rocket ship that they sort of project launching off the castle from Rapunzel, where those lights come up all over the castle. So it's really amazing what they do with those projections. The fireworks are fantastic. If you haven't seen it before, I would recommend Happily Ever After, that fireworks show. Now, there is another show afterwards, a projection show on the castle. I've seen parts of it, but not all of it. It really does look cool, and I want to see more of this show. But Happily Ever After is amazing, and I think most people stay for Happily Ever After as opposed to that other show, maybe because they forget there's another show, or maybe because that's the one to see. But fireworks are included on that first show, Happily Ever After show. It's really a fantastic view. It can get a little bit crowded, so if you want to see that one, and if you want to get a front row seat, if you will, make sure you get there early. But it is a fantastic show. Number 10, last but definitely not least for me right now as I'm thinking about this, is the Tiki Room. Now, it was a tough choice. There's a lot of great rides and attractions at the Magic Kingdom, and it's so hard to choose. So we'll touch on some of those honorable mentions here in a second. But for me, the Tiki Room, especially if you've never been to Disney and if you've never been to the Magic Kingdom, is such a classic. To see those animatronics, to see those birds, and to see other members of the Tiki Room singing and performing for you and telling you those stories of the jungle and kind of what that's like. It's really amazing. You know, they do some great music. They tell a fantastic story. The more I sort of reminisce about that one, the more I want to go back and see it, you know, and I don't feel like I've seen it often enough. And I think part of the challenge with that one is it's a long attraction. So if you find yourself going in line for the Tiki Room, it can take a while if the last show just started. So it's kind of hard to time when to get in line to actually see the show as efficiently as possible. But the animatronics are just amazing. If you've never seen them before, I would recommend them. I think it's a show that's worth checking out. And of course, the honorable mentions. Magic Kingdom has so many honorable mentions. To choose these 10 was not easy for me. Let me know what you thought, if you agree with some of these 10, or if you'd prioritize some other ones above these. But let me talk to you about some of my honorable mentions. The Haunted Mansion. Haunted Mansion has some amazing theming. The castle, it's a dark ride where you sit in a doom buggy and you ride around the castle, sort of see some of these scarier creatures and kind of the ghost stories that they tell you. It really is an amazing ride to see some of the animatronics that went into that and some of those projections. They do some amazing ghostly work with projections, with visuals. So if you haven't seen Haunted Mansion, I would recommend that one as well. Another one I love is Peter Pan. Now you'd think, Peter Pan, that seems sort of simple, sort of basic. But again, I love the attention to detail in that dark ride. You're flying over this world, you're seeing sort of Wendy's house, and you're seeing Captain Hook and some of these sea battles that some of the characters have. So really, really beautiful animations, beautiful sort of artwork that they've built into Peter Pan, and that makes it one of my favorite attractions to see in Magic Kingdom as well. Now, there's so many other honorable mentions that come to mind in the Magic Kingdom. Again, Magic Kingdom's got so many good ones. Again, what comes to mind for me, you've got Jungle Cruise. Jungle Cruise, fantastic. Small World, if you've never seen it, that's a staple, a classic. But I just wanted to touch on an initial 10 here. If I had to pick 10, this is where I would start, and that may change next time, you know, but I want to make sure that you have some good ideas of some food, some fireworks shows, and some rides you may want to go on at the Magic Kingdom. What did you think of this video? Do you agree with me? Do you disagree? Do you like this sort of video? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Thank you so much for being a part of the fun with me today. For more fun, family-friendly adventures, make sure you hit that subscribe button and ring the bell to stay informed. And until next time, play on.